Hey everybody, this is Rutted Bus or Rutted Games, and as you know, I just recently started up my channel, and I thought it'd be fun to do a solo playthrough of a game. And for my first game, I decided I want to do Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 2. I just recently played through this, and it was a pretty fun game. It was an epic journey, and I really loved the story. Actually, I enjoyed it more than that, the first original Knights of the Old Republic. And so, I think it'd be nice to experience this with you again. So, we're going to start up a new game. And we're going to create our character. So, Jedi Consulars, male Jedi Consular. Jedi Consulars are masters of the Force and spend less time on combat training. Recommended for advanced players only. Jedi Sentinels are well balanced and possess many skills. And Jedi Guardians focus on combat training and lightsaber mastery. And usually, I really enjoy the Force powers, so I'm probably gonna go male Jedi Consular. So we're gonna create a custom character for my portrait. Don't like his hair. That's usually who I pick, actually. That's my favorite portrait. I think I want to go with Lando Calrissian. This is good. Smuggler's vibe. That's what I get from him. Like his mustache. Attributes. So, I like a good high constitution, and I like strength. Charisma is pretty important to me. So is wisdom. And intelligence. Yeah, I'm not too big into. Well, when I level up my character, I tend to start leveling up dexterity a little bit more. But I feel like strength and constitution are the most important ones so far. And at least for the early game, and later on, when you start using the lightsaber, the strength really helps you land your hits. And the constitution, well, let's just say there's this item you need later on where you need at least minimum 16. So you'd be able to get like +4 in every single skill system. How do we want to go about this? I love persuade. Treat injury. I think that's pretty good. Actually, you know what? Back. Skills. Security could use one. Persuade, I can afford to go 3 for right now. And this is more like how I want it. Security is also pretty important to get a lot of good items from chests that you find. Two weapon fighting. I always go double saber, and plus I love just stacking up on weapons and dealing so much damage. And for our name, what should we choose? I'm not gonna go Rutted Bus because that seems like such a weird name for Star Wars. I think I'll go. I'm not gonna use my real name. I don't really want too many people knowing my real name, so. Let's do. Jade. We'll just go Jade. You know what? No. Alright, so this is kind of tough finding a name I actually want to use. What seems Star Warsy enough? I think Kandor is a good name. That seems like it would fit into the Star Wars universe. So we'll go Kandor. A long time ago in a galaxy far, far. This is epic. And sorry, I noticed you guys can't see the cutscenes, so I'll just narrate them for you. It is a perilous time for the galaxy. A brutal civil war has all but destroyed the Jedi Order. leaving the ailing Republic on the verge of collapse. Amid the turmoil, the evil Sith have spread across the galaxy, hunting down and destroying the remaining Jedi Knights. Narrowly escaping a deadly Sith ambush, the last known Jedi clings to life aboard a battered freighter near the ravaged world of Paradis. And I apologize about the cutscenes, but this is something, for some reason OBS can't record the cutscenes. I've already tried to fix it, but it might just be a problem with KOTOR, because it records the game fine, just not the cutscenes. So I apologize, I'll try my best to narrate them, and if there's any text, I'll read it out to you, because when my character talks, I'll read out what I want to say, in case any of you are just listening through audio. Camera's panning down. We see a lot of asteroids and what looks to be the Ebon Hawk traveling towards. It looks like a star. It might be a planet. And if you don't know, the Ebon Hawk is the original ship that Revan and his crew pilots. Oh. Can you guys see this? Alright. I guess I don't need to narrate this. It might just be some cutscenes. I have no idea, really, why it doesn't work. Proximity alert. Seems like, I think we're playing as T3 right now. Yeah. Alright.
The Ebon Hawk is adrift in space after a terrible battle. Most of its crew are dead or dying. You lie in the medical room in critical condition. You won't survive long without medical attention.
Look at that mustache.
Main power must be restored in order to bring the engines online and dock with the nearby Paragus mining station for much needed repairs. Your fate and that of the Ebon Hawk depend upon T3M4, a lone astromech droid. Return to this location at any time to skip the prologue.
Alright, since some of you probably have never seen this game before, we'll continue with the prologue.
Press WASD.
Active quest screen includes important information related to your ongoing adventures. Refer to this journal for hints and guidance throughout the game.
You have new quests. To view your quests, open the game menu, default Escape, and look in the journal, default J.
Alright, the Ebon Hawk is heavily damaged and adrift in a dangerous asteroid field. Find the hyperdrive and fix it to restore primary power so that you can dock with the Paragus mining station for repairs. Heal Kandor bonus mission. Kandor is lying in a medbay in critical condition. You can use a med pack to stabilize his vitals. To fully revive Kandor, it will require the medical facilities at the Paragus mining station. Alright, so it seems like we're gonna have to fix the hyperdrive.
This room contains a class field cylinder and the communications console. Target
one of these objects, move closer to it, left click on it, or press Q or E to cycle through the available target. To interact with an object, first target it, and then left click on it. You know what? It might be my headset, but I think I'm just going to turn up the voice. Just turn up on the volume a little bit. Computer spike.
You'll come across many containers, some of which will be locked. The computer spike you just picked up can be used at computer terminals to access functions, such as opening doors.
Alright, let's check the communications console. Success, you have selected the Ebon Hawk computer bypassing the main console functions. Open the main hold containment door. Log out.
This is the main hold.
Let's check the security console. We need spikes.
Your security skill is too low to open this footlock.
Alright, some locked doors and containers can be opened by bashing or blasting them with the weapon until they open. not all doors or containers can be successfully bashed. To bash an object, select it, then select bash from the target tool. And I believe it should just auto bash for us. Nice. Tanami's boss.
Sometimes bashing or blowing open the container will break some of the items in the container. But you can use even broken items. They can be turned into useful components at a workbench.
Alright, so now we have our two computer spikes. Let's slice into the security console. Computer, slice the system two spikes. You have sliced into the Ebonhawk security system for the port aft section of the ship, which includes the engine room, utility lift, and a garage. Ebonhawk port aft security menu, enter command. Active security cameras. Let's view the garage door camera. Outer. Okay. Inner garage. It's all broken, all the same. Engine room, broken again. Utility lift, surprisingly intact. Access security doors. So we close the door. Let's just open everything. Alright, close outer garage door. Open inner garage door. Warning, cold breach in garage section, blast doors locked down. Error, low security door remote operation offline. Engine room door inoperable. Inner garage door working, outer garage door working. Log out. So let's see our new journal entry. Prologue, garage access bonus mission. The garage is depressurized and you can only open the inner garage door if you close the outer garage door and vice versa. To access it, you will need two droids. Switch to solo mode and move the first droid to stand in the hall between the inner and outer garage doors. Then switch to the second droid and move to the security terminal in the main hold. For second droid, use the security terminal to close the outer garage door and open the inner garage door. Then switch back to the first droid and you should be able to proceed into the garage. So now we're gonna have to go find a second droid. Let's see if we can open this low security door. Worked.
If you need help exploring the Ebonhawk, access the map screen by pressing M.
So just to show you the map screen, there it is. That's the whole Ebonhawk. It's not that big.
This is the medical room. You are in critical condition. You will need.
Let's see if this has a med pack in there. Oh!
You have found med packs. You can use one to stabilize the condition of the human lying on the bed.
Let's stabilize
the med pack
myself.
Can use
the med
Success.
Pack.
Success! You are stabilized. To recover fully, you will require the medical facilities at the Paragus mining station. But you are not in any danger of dying from your wounds right now. This lift will take you to the outer hull of the Ebonhawk, where you will find many parts and mines to use for accessing and repairing the hyperdrive. Use the lift controls to go up. This is the utility lift. You can use this lift to take you to the outside of the Ebonhawk.
Let's go outside. That's pretty cool. Just being outside in space reminds me of the scene from episode 1 where R2-D2 and his astromech droids go out there.
This is the starboard side of the Ebonhawk.
Now's a good time to save. And what I tend to do is... Alright, new slot. Let's see. What do we name this? Save game? Just Kandor. Then save game. New slot, save, back up. Usually I have two saves, one just to back it up, and one with my actual name, engine port. Let's get the parts from there.
This busted engine port has some needed parts for the Ebonhawk's hyperdrive. Take the parts here back down below to get main power restored. These exposed wires control the door to the starboard dormitory. Success.
So we just overrode the starboard dorm. What's up here? Let's just see.
Don't forget to explore the other side. This is the port side. The bubbles ahead indicate mines that you've detected automatically with your awareness skill. Some mines require higher awareness to detect. Approach mines carefully. They will blow up and damage you if you get too close. You can use your demolition skill to either disable or recover these mines. Recovering mines requires a higher demolition skill than disabling them, but you get to keep the mine, which you can then use to set as a trap for enemies or break down into components at a workbench.
Alright, simple enough, just recognize, disable, or recover the mine. I believe recovering the mine takes a higher demolition skill, but let's try it. Let's try it anyway. And it worked. So, mines aren't too useful in this game. I hardly ever actually put, that's just not my playstyle to put down traps for my enemies. But I can see the, why some people would do that.
There is an explosive device in this missile to blow open the engine room door inside the Ebon Hawk. This will give you access to the hyperdrive. After you plant a mine, back away quickly so that you do not take damage.
And let's
this
just
is
open
the
hatch.
Side of the Ebon Hawk.
Let's get the
this
items.
Open hatch has some parts that will be useful for getting main power restored.
And let's go back down.
You can use this lid to take.
I don't think we have to listen to the lady say that. Outer garage door.
There is a hull breach in the area beyond this door. Safety protocols prevent you from opening it manually. Try using the security computer in the main hold.
So,
this is the engine room.
We won't go into there for now. You see.
This is the main hold.
Access security doors open. We'll close the inner and open the outer. We'll log out. And let's see if we can find a droid in here. No. So, we're gonna have to go look for a droid. He might be in here. And there he is.
Talking to other characters is much like using the computer console in the cockpit. Scroll through your response options or move the mouse cursor, and then click to select a response. Note that some responses may influence how other characters react to you, so choose carefully. Furthermore, certain skills, powers, and attributes may modify what choices you have, or how successful you are with those choices.
So let's talk to this droid.
3CFD is malfunctioning. You can fix him by using a part. Luckily, you have already found one. If you repair 3CFD, he can join your party and assist you in repairing the ship.
Let's repair him.
Success! You have fixed 3CFD. Now he will join your party.
Invite. Alright, so
3CFD is now a member of your party. To change which party member you control, click on the portrait or press tab. Later, you can have more companions. This is the main hole.
Alright, so solo mode, I believe, is me. Yes. So, we'll put you in here. Check this truck and boy. Alright. Switch characters. And now you. No, it's not through there. Access the security console. Close the outer. Open the inner. Log out. And we're in. I'm stupid. Oh. Close the inner garage door and open the outer. I'm still stupid. Where's the garage door? Where is it? No. Alright, now we found it. They're not. No. Let's log out. Let's switch. Alright, now we're in. Let's read this journal entry. You've access to a garage. In the garage is a workbench. You should use the workbench to break down extra objects in your inventory into components. Use the components to create a repair kit.
This is a workbench. With a workbench, you can break down objects in your inventory into components. You can then use the components to create repair kits, weapons, armor, and upgrades. Because of the damage to the Ebon Hawk, this workbench has limited functionality. You can still use it to create a repair kit, which you can use to repair yourself. Use the workbench to break down the items you've found into components. Then use the components to create a repair kit.
Now's a good time to save again. Workbench. Use the workbench. Repair kit. Parts. Let's see, where are the components? Let's look, create new items. Whoo, where are the components? Ouch. Don't make me go through this.
These sparking wires connect to the trigger mechanism.
Close the inner garage door.
Door closed. Do you want to
open the
door? Do you want?
Do nothing. Let's get T3 in here. All right, where was the way? This should be through here. All right. I'm stupid. I don't know how to get there.
This is the main hole.
Oh, okay, okay. We pass the lift and then we go in. Alright. Let's close
door.
Here.
Do you?
Alright. You should be able to repair yourself. No. Oh, let's break down this broken item into breakdown item. All right, I'm stupid. Let's create this item. And then let's use this repair kit on ourselves.
This blast door is magnetically sealed and cannot be opened. This is the starboard dormitory. We found a droid flamethrower. This is one of the special weapons the droids can use. To equip it, open the equip screen by clicking on the button. This is the starboard dormitory.
This lady just goes on and on.
When the Ebon Hawk has landed,
No, lady, please do not.
The garage.
Please. Is this all you wanted me to do here?
These spark.
Do nothing. Let's read the journal. Get through here.
This is the garage.
Solo mode. Alright. Let's just get T3 through there. And let's go open, blow open the engine.
This is the main hole. This blast door is
This is not the engine room. Let's make use of our map and stop being so stupid. Hyperdrive. Cargo hold. Dormitory. Garage. Evan Hawk exit. Storage compartment. How am I so lost in the Evan Hawk? I'm stupid. Why did I not read? Alright, take a right. It's okay. It's okay. Left clicking the mouse while the mind is selected in your action menu completes the mind. You can also disable and recover enemy mines and add them to your own inventory for later use.
This is the engine room. The hyperdrive is suffering badly. You won't be able to make the jump. However, you should be able to rig the hyperdrive to restore primary power and bring the port engine online. This will allow you to dock with the Paragus mining station for full repairs.
Rig the hyperdrive.
Success! The hyperdrive is online and primary power is restored. Only one step remains. Return to the galaxy map in the cockpit and travel to Paragus.
Journal entry added. Prologue, save the Evan Hawk. You've restored power to the hyperdrive. Now return to the galaxy map in the cockpit of the Evan Hawk and travel to Paragus. This is now another good time to save, so we'll save into our backup. And we'll just go up through here.
This is the main hold.
We know that. He's probably gonna tell us this is.
This is the cockpit.
Okay.
You can now plot a course to the Paragus mining station. To dock with Paragus, left click on the Paragus planet to select it. And then left click on the travel button.
Man. Just travel. Yep. I feel like it's these cutscenes where you can't see him, but the Evan Hawk is just gliding through space right now. And I apologize for this. We're docking into an asteroid, which I guess is a mining station. You could probably hear the audio. And again, I apologize, but there's not really much I can do.
The sensors show the door to the storage compartment is being sliced. There is someone, or something, else alive on the Evan Hawk.
Oh no. Is that HK? That's HK. And by the way, yeah, the screen is black for me too. That was on purpose. And there we are. Even in stasis, the stash still looks good. We look like we're throwing up, dry heaving. And we crawl out. Just get up. Just get up. We're getting up. But it seems like our hands aren't even touching the ground. Alright, so we just went through the prologue, we'll save the game right now, and again, this is where I believe, let's pause it right here, this is where I believe we'll end it for right now since we just beat the prologue and I think it's about 20 to 30 minutes. This is going to be a fun time. I apologize for the cutscene problem again, and I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll certainly bring some more back, And we'll start off from here. Alright, thanks.